you and Francesca approach me to go along with them because she has an immunity idol. Jeff, I'm a former special agent.
You are a crazy person.
I know for a fact that Christina and Phillip were lying. But it doesn't take a genius FBI man to figure that out. All you have to do is look at their faces and watch their lips moving.
I almost got you.
I
always have to say some things from my heart to you.
Until
I go to redemption, you own my vote.
Thank you, brother.
When I come back, I'm a competitor, like I said.
This guy, Phillip, FBI, whatever, special agent, he is a piece of work. He told me that I own his vote for the rest of the time he's here until he goes to Redemption Island.
I want to play to the level of integrity. When I say something, it means something today. That's really...
I don't know if he's delusional. I think he's a good-hearted guy. I do. Just might not all be there. Let it be a lesson to you. Government jobs... stressful.
Right there, look at that. Just missed it.
When I went hunting for the crabs, you know, you find yourself going back to that primal state. There's a part of you that comes to a place where you realize that here in Survivor, you are going to be tested in so many ways.
The fine specimen is creeping up on his prey.
He has his pink shorts on.
They attract the crabs.
When I revealed to the girls that I was a former federal agent, it was designed to let the girls know that I am a trustworthy person. And at tribal council last night, Francesca maligned my character. And I was definitely impacted emotionally because one of the things about me is that I love my country. Having worn the uniform that I swore that I was prepared to protect and defend, to have her try to take some of that pride I have, and having served as a special agent and earned the right to be called trustworthy, it hurt me. It made me angry. I had lots of emotional feelings going on.
Got him.
And I think the best lesson I got from last night for me personally, besides the game aspects, was I still love Phillip Shepard. He's a good guy, and that's okay.
Ah-hoo-ah! Killed with a stone, baby.
All right, you guys ready to get to today's immunity challenge?
Yes, sir.
First things first, Ralph, I will take it back.
I'll get it back.
Oh, yeah? All right.
See you tonight.
Phillip, does that inspire you when somebody kind of throws that in your face and says, this baby's coming back with us?
Oh, it brings out the animal in me. I will outlast any man over there.
What about the women?
That's another day. We'll see.
Phillip. I asked you before the challenge, does this bring out the animal in you? And you said absolutely.
The gorilla, powerful animal, won't attack anyone unless provoked. A lion, one of the few animals that no animal, whether it's starving to death, will approach. For me, that's how I feel about my family and my country. You do something to the United States, that full power is gonna come at you. You try to attack my family in any way, you get the lion, baby.
The game is always on. In the past, I ignored the hidden immunity idol. Well, that didn't turn out too good for me. So this time around, I decided maybe I can learn something too. So I'm starting to look for him, and I'm starting to be diligent about it. I went through everything, and it was nowhere. I look over and I see Phillip's fat ass bend in the chair about to break it. How's it feel?
Feels good.
Why's it lopsided?
It's probably missing a screw, and I'm probably not on even ground.
Oh, hold on. Yeah, don't, because we're gonna break it.
Think so?
It's over here. Get a screw. I look down at the hidden immunity idol clue. It's right underneath his ass. It's sitting sewn inside the fabric of the chair.
I gotta fix this.
I think I have a screw in the toolbox. How lucky was that? Had Phillip not been so fat, that chair wouldn't have been bending as much, and I wouldn't have told him to move.
This morning, while everybody was trying to sleep, Phillip was up at the crack of dawn, sweeping. He's just a pain in the butt. He's so annoying and he's so weird.
Saggy bottom, dude. Saggy bottoms. I go
life
39 days without seeing that.
Phillip is a piece of work. I mean, who comes on Survivor and wears pink tidy whities with his stuff just hanging out and, you know, just flopping around everywhere? It's not only disturbing, it's actually disgusting. It's like your dad should have bought a new pair like months ago. You don't want your friends coming over to play and seeing that.
These young people out here, they don't understand me. They don't know if I'm a criminal or a school teacher. They don't know how to take me. So I'm a little frustrated out here.
Gross.
Given that this is a social game, it's a huge disadvantage for me.
So there has to be another side of me that emerges. The guy that's undercover. Because I'll tell you this much, I'm prepared to do what I need to do to win $1 million.
So, how about a brief tribal meeting real quickly here? I know we're all feeling a little down right now. We would have liked to have won. That said, I thought we did pretty good overall. You know, we all put forth a great effort. Hey, anybody got anything? Okay, let's get to it.
Man, we can't win a challenge. It's tough already, and Phillip, you never want to shy away from a moment in the sun. I mean, at this point, there's like an utter malice towards him that's palpable.
You guys ready to pour it?
Yeah, we're gonna pour it.
You want me to do it?
Nope, I got it.
You gotta see this. Just be very careful. I wish you moved away from there completely. Like this with your feet. You see, they're not coming so close.
Phillip, I cannot stand him. Like, can't even look at him. That's how bad I can't stand him. And I think we're all on the same page. But, you know, we gotta go to tribal tonight, so we might as well make the best of it. I just hope Phillip goes home.
When I come back from a loss, the very last thing that I really want to have to endure is Phillip's yammering. Going to tribal tonight, I'm thinking it's myself or Phillip going home. I'm on the wrong side of the numbers in this tribe. I have been since day one. At the same time, they might
How do you define
Phillip.
Weak?
Because I think weak in this case might be disruptiveness.
Who qualifies as being disruptive?
Oh, I think Phil's a little disruptive. I think he's a little assertive, and I think that he's uncomfortable for some people at times.
Phillip, is that something you've faced in life before, being a little disruptive?
No, I wouldn't characterize it that at all. I'm actually a doer, and I'm one of those people that if you're not about pulling your share and you show up right at mealtime, I probably am a little disruptive to him.
He threw it right back at you, Christina.
That's what he does. You know, I do a lot of stuff around camp, too, just about as much as you do, Phil, and
I would beg to differ.
Well, anyways, I mean, I do a lot of stuff, too, so
the last 3 days you have, yes.
So, Phillip, clearly you think it should be Christina tonight. Christina, you clearly think it should be Phillip.
Well, for me, I have a history with the tribe. They know what I'm about.
You're a doer.
It's just what I call the shepherd stamp. Tonight, Christina went home after a 4-3 vote, 3 for me, 4 for her.
Not too surprising, I suspected it. There's a very close alliance with Rob and several others in the group. They've been running the show from the get-go. And I'm kind of like the odd man out around here. Even though I think I bring a lot to this tribe, and soon a couple of people are going to have to wake up and realize that.
Ready for bed.
And can we move down a little bit that way? You and I are going to be real good buddies today.
Yes. You get your underwear on?
I have my underwear on, but that doesn't stop me, brother.
Phillip is bugging everyone, including myself. He's completely off his rocker, walking around in his pink panties. Nobody trusts them.
It's like seriously hurting my eyes.
As long as Phillip is aggravating everybody so much, it takes all the heat off of me. So in a way, maybe he needs to stay.
Rob and Grant stepped away to go watch the duel at Redemption Island. So, kind of a funny kind of day for me. For me, it's just like, I can't make an impression on these ladies, so it's frustrating for me.
These girls remind me of crabs, to be honest, back at camp, you know. Particularly Natalie and Ashley have a very difficult time trying to approach them. They're quick to move away. They see me coming, and they don't want to have a conversation with me about it. They definitely remind me of crap.
They can't engage with
me. So can I ask you something?
Sure.
Honestly,
yeah.
There hasn't been any point in this game, none whatsoever, that you tried to throw me under the bus or do anything against my...
Never.
Never?
Never.
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 Okay. No. Oh my gosh, the chocolate donut.
Oh my God.
I can't even choose a favorite. Like, I love muffins. Those muffins, it was like apple cinnamon or something, and it was so good.
Yummy to victory!
We got a win today. You get to see my beautiful wife more often.
Yeah.
I wonder what sugar does, you see?
I know.
No.
Sugar is nice.
For a massage, I give up half a donut.
Listen, we have three. Oh, yeah, Phillip was like, I'll trade a donut if someone gives me a massage. I was like, I wouldn't give you a massage for a dozen donuts, buddy.
Girls, I have a request.
Yeah.
And that is, every half an hour or so, check on the fire.
Do you know that I do that?
I know you do. So okay. I'm not singling you out.
Right.
I'm just saying, you know, I've been up over there like four or five times this morning just doing it. So what I want to try to do is like every 25 minutes, half an hour, you guys kind of work it out amongst yourself.
Okay.
Because we got wet wood around here for the next couple of days.
Okay.
So I've got it stoking right now.
Thank you, Phillip.
All right, thanks, okay. Guys.
Thanks, Billy. By your face!
If I go to Redemption Island before Ashley and Natalie, there's something wrong with the game because those two girls, they're on a beauty pageant. That's their whole world. But it's hard to compete and do anything when you got two girls who won't get off their butt and they don't give you real credit for anything. It's reminding me of, you know, when somebody who don't like dogs pet a dog. You've seen that. I'm their redheaded stepchild. These two girls must go. They've been here 14 days, and frankly, the pageant is over.